I'm curious, Anderson, how often do you buy bottled water?
Almost never.
Almost never.
Maybe in the summer, I'll buy like one every couple of weeks or something. Mm-hmm. I don't buy a lot of water. Why?
So you don't drink water?
I drink water. I'm usually at home when I'm drinking water, or I drink your bottled water. Because you buy it. You buy it for our workplace. So.
Yes. So I buy a lot of bottled water.
Mm-hmm.
For yours.
Yes,
for me and for our customers.
Yeah, but not for me.
But for you.
Not for me.
I found this news on the internet the other day. A science found a really big issue. 24,000 tiny plastic pieces in just one bottle water.
I think I saw that news also. Mm. Yeah.
I think this is like a tiny fracture of the plastic.
Yes.
That no one can see.
Right. It's like minuscule, tiny, 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 yes. tiny pieces yes. of plastic in your water. So actually, that's one reason why I don't buy plastic.
Oh, did you know this?
I mean, I knew it. I didn't know the number. I didn't know it was 240,000 pieces. But I knew that obviously there is plastic in your water when you buy plastic bottles. So that's one reason. The other is I just don't like to make a lot of plastic trash. Mm-hmm. I don't like actively avoid buying something because it's in plastic, except plastic drinks. I don't buy a lot of drinks in plastic bottles if I can help it.
Okay. So they say there are way more than they expected.
Yes.
So and this is important because it makes us think about how these tiny plastics might affect our health and the planet.
Very definitely. So I think it was a few years ago, some different scientists found, I don't know what it's called. Like if you have a fleece jacket that's made from recycled plastic bottles, if you wash that, you know, the fabric kind of breaks off and goes into the water, and then that water is sent out to the sea. So even water that has been cleaned, there's still plastic in the water that goes out to the sea. So these scientists found like tiny, tiny, tiny pieces of plastic inside the fish.
Mm.
And those fish, that's our food. We're eating fish, right? Mm. So then basically we're just eating plastic.
Oh, no.
With our seafood.
Oh, no.
So it does actually affect our health. You have to think about when you're eating seafood.
Yeah.
Where has that fish been swimming? What has the fish been eating and drinking?
Yeah, but realistically, we can't keep track where the fish is swimming in the ocean.
No, no. So the point is, like, don't put plastic in the water.
Right.
Because we can't keep track of the fish, and the water goes everywhere, and the fish go everywhere. So the best way is don't pollute our water.
Right. Yeah. I think it's impossible to reduce number of pet bottle we produce every year. But how can we try to reduce usage of pet bottles?
Well, I'm not like super gung-ho, but I know a few people here who just refuse to buy plastic.
Mm-hmm.
They'll take a steel, what do you call it? Like in Japanese, a suito.
Suito, yes.
A thermos or a flask with them.
Yes.
You fill it up at home, and you take it out with you. Or, you know, if it runs out, you can fill it up, you know, somewhere with water and just drink that.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, some people just don't buy plastic.
Yes. Yeah. So I've been thinking about getting water server.
Yeah, you can do things like that. Like the reason we or you have to buy bottled water or use a water server is because the building we're in, the pipes are not safe.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to bring water in. But like normally at home, I don't buy bottled water. I just use tap water.
Mm-hmm.
And then I try to filter it if it's going to be used directly, like for coffee and tea and like drinking water.
Yeah.
But just tap water at home is usually fine.
Mm. Yeah. After we got a water server, maybe we can reduce plastic from our body, I guess.
I hope so, yeah. But the water in the water server is also in plastic. So
just, yeah, that's what I thought.
Just so you know. It's kind of the same thing.
True.
It's just the size of the bottle is different. Is it this size or is it this size? Yeah, it's different. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh my God. We can't escape from plastic.
It's hard. In Japan, it's very hard. Everything is in plastic in Japan.
But
Everything.
How do people in the US drink water? Do they drink from out of air or?
I don't know how they drink water, but I think a lot of people use tap water just filter it at home. They have filtration systems at home that they use. And honestly, some people do use bottled water or water servers. You know, it can't be avoided.
Right.
But as far as plastic in general, for example, when we go to the grocery store, like in Japan, everything is in a plastic bag. Everything.
Yes.
But in Europe and America, fruit and vegetables are sold like piece by piece. Mm. In Japanese, you say baraudi. Mm-hmm. It's baraudi. So you don't have to have plastic on it. Mm-hmm. And you just pick up the ones you want and take that to the register. Mm-hmm. And it's usually by weight.
Yes.
So the register, they'll have a scale and they weigh how much your apples and how much your bananas are and charge you that way.
Yes.
So that's one way we avoid some plastic. Mm.